that the fellowship is designed for a very specific purpose, which is this, that the foundation is working with a vision towards a better society, a more just, equitable, humane, sustainable society. And the foundation sees its work towards such a society through its contribution in trying to help improve the public education system in India, right? Now, that's what the foundation does. Now, it's quite clear to us that if you look at this vast country, there are very many people who are fired up by the idea of contributing to society. A very large percentage of them also think that one of the most important ways of contributing to a good society is actually through school education. A very large percentage of them are actually not in education. They're doing something else. They might be working in a business organization. They might be teaching in a college. They might be working in some other social sector area. Now, what are the possibilities for such people? How can they actually figure out a way by which they can actually bring to life their idea that they must contribute to society through school education? So the Azim Premji Foundation Fellowship is designed for people who are of this kind. We want such people to come and join the fellowship. The fellowship is very rigorously and thoughtfully designed, such that it gives them an intense personal experience of what does it mean to be actually in school education? What does it mean? What does it take, right, to really contribute to school education? And not in any some dreamy-eyed manner. You know, the real dirt and grime and difficulty and challenges of this school education system, and, you know, both metaphorically and physically, right? So the fellowship gives them that option. And so we're hoping that people from these backgrounds will take the opportunity, come and join, experience this stuff intensely. And then, of course, that they will learn and they'll continue to contribute, right? And that they should continue with school education, that they should continue with the foundation and contribute to school education and therefore to society.
Previously, I was working on the issues of human trafficking with an organization named MSEMVS Varanasi. Since I was working with the human trafficking issue, so वहाँ पे एक opportunity थी कि मैं communities के साथ बहुत closely काम करता था. In that process, I got to know about the various social evil existing in society, whether it's health, poverty or illiteracy. So one thing I realized was that कि जहाँ पे education या sensitized नहीं है और they are not aware about their rights, educated नहीं है, they are more vulnerable to the these kinds of social evil.
So I was looking out for teaching opportunities. My previous experiences were about going behind the theoretical aspects of education. I didn't have a practical experience of having involved in schools or in other places, like being with the students and understanding what are the hindrances and obstacles they face. I think that is a key area through which you can get into the society to make any kind of transformation.
फेलोशिप ये अलग अलग सेक्टर के लोगों को एजुकेशन में लाते हैं कि आप अलग सेक्टर का जब आएगा इंसान तो वो एजुकेशन को समझेगा किस तरीके से, आखिर एजुकेशन है क्या, गवर्नमेंट स्कूल्स में आखिर किस तरीके के बच्चे आ रहे हैं, टीचर्स कर क्या रहे हैं. क्योंकि एक आम धारणा जो हमारी बनी हुई है कि गवर्नमेंट स्कूल के टीचर जो हैं एब्सेंट रहते हैं, आधे से ज़्यादा काम नहीं करते हैं स्कूलों में. एक सरकारी कर्मचारी को लेकर जिस तरीके की अवधारणा है, और वही गवर्नमेंट टीचर्स के लिए भी हमारी एक अवधारणा है कि काम करते ही नहीं है बिल्कुल ये. तो जब अलग सेक्टर के लोग आएंगे, एजुकेशन को समझेंगे, देखेंगे आखिर टीचर्स कर क्या रहे हैं स्कूलों में और बच्चे किस परिवेश के आ रहे हैं और उनको किस तरीके से टीचर सिखा रहा है, एक टीचर के ऊपर कितनी ज़्यादा जिम्मेदारियां हैं. अगर आप किसी प्राइमरी स्कूल में जाके देखेंगे तो एक गवर्नमेंट टीचर बहुत सारे रोल्स प्ले कर रहा है वहाँ पर. एक टीचर का है, सफाई भी उसी को करनी होती है, ऑफिशियल काम भी सारा उसी को करना होता है, मिड डे मील भी सारा उसी को देखना पड़ता है, SMC से लेकर और कम्युनिटी में भी उसी का रोल रहता है पूरी तरीके से. और हमारे देश में बहुत सारे स्कूल जो सिंगल टीचर स्कूल्स हैं, तो आप एक टीचर को देख सकते हैं कितनी ज़्यादा वो मेहनत करता है. उसके बाद भी हम उस पर इस तरीके आरोप प्रत्यारोप करते हैं कि वो पढ़ा नहीं रहा है स्कूलों में, कम से कम पढ़ा ही रहा है, यही बहुत बड़ी बात है.
फेलोशिप इट्सेल्फ इज़ वेरी यूनिक एंड अ बिग प्लेटफॉर्म. आई मीन आई एम अ वर्किंग प्रोफेशनल. फॉर मी आई एम इंडिपेंडेंट financially I'm independent. So somehow it provides me, addresses my financial aspect also. At the same time, at this stage of my career, I'm from a different domain. I get to introduce to the education sector what are the challenges and that kind of exposure they give, whether it's school practice, whether it's getting exposure with the teachers or the government officials. So it's a very interesting platform for the working professional. Broadly, we can categorize in like we're working on four aspects. Definitely, first step, school learning, school practices. Then there is self-capacity building. It's about reading books, getting more knowledge about the various education system, writing, report writings, and then interaction with the teachers, dialogues with the government officials, and definitely school community. So what are their roles and responsibilities? So it's been a great journey. Abhi school practices kar rahe hain, school learning kar rahe hain. So har tarah ke aspect ko samajhne ka mauka mil raha hai.
So my school runs down 2 kilometers down the mountain, and I used to just walk down the mountains. And in between there are a small naturally created waterfalls also during the rainfall. So right now I am concentrating on English. So I have begun with the action words also, and I prepared TLMs also. I prepared chart preparations also. And recently this school was known to no one. Means out of a period of 13 schools, that school lagged around 13th, on the 13th position. Now, recently, day before yesterday, a block level report came where there was an English dictation competition, and the school stood first in that. So that this is a pride moment for me, and I wrote a report also in regards to it. Saw the smiles in the faces of the children, that they feel happy after 6 to 7 years of time, because the school has also gained reputation. The teachers were also thanking me that, okay, because of you that this happened, the school reached the topmost position. So this is a good thing for me. This inspires me most to do more and more and more.
Earlier, I was more concerned about what kind of education we are giving, but here I see the obstacles and hurdles. And I think that is a rich input that I'll take from this fellowship program. Earlier, I used to be working in a corporate office, and although it was in the sphere of education, I used to do my job, go back home and not care about what happens next. Now it's more like I have taken the role of a teacher educator now, and I will be involved with students as well as teachers. And it's not just the responsibilities that come with the job, it's also about how you get along with the students and the teachers, and they actually have some respect for the kind of contribution I make, and I can see the impact it has on a daily basis.
फेलोशिप में आने से पहले जो मेरे अंदर एक अवधारणा थी गवर्नमेंट टीचर्स और गवर्नमेंट स्कूल्स को लेकर, वो पूरी तरीके से चेंज हो चुकी है. पहले मैं सोचता था कि टीचर्स वाकई पढ़ाते नहीं हैं, या जो बच्चे जाते हैं मिड डे मील के लिए जाते हैं या इस तरीके से. तो जब मैं यहाँ आया, मैंने एजुकेशन को देखा, तो लगा कि वाकई टीचर तो बहुत ज़्यादा एफर्ट करते हैं, बहुत मेहनत करते हैं.
ऑनेस्टली आई नेवर फेल्ट लाइक कि मैं एक फेलोशिप प्रोग्राम में आया हूँ. आई हैव ऑलवेज फेल्ट लाइक कि मैं एक टीम का मेम्बर ही हूँ, पार्ट ऑफ द टीम. मुझे कुकिंग नहीं आती थी, चपातीज रोटीज बनाना नहीं आता था. दैट इज़ समथिंग मैं यहाँ पर आया और मैंने सीखा. एक फीमेल को लेके आ गया मैं, और उसने 3 दिन लिटरली मुझे चपातीज और बनाना सिखाया. इनिशियली मुझे अकोमोडेशन का प्रॉब्लम था, आई हैव स्टेड विद वन ऑफ द सीनियर मेम्बर फॉर अ मंथ. सो इट हैज़ बीन अ गुड सपोर्ट.
द कल्चर हियर इज़ वेरी फ्रेंडली, इट्स नॉट लाइक स्ट्रिक्ट मंडेन kind of a environment. You colleagues are no longer colleagues as such, they are friends. So it's working as a family together, making some changes and being excited about what you do and all that is really is what is interesting in every day.
So mera advice yahi hai ki aakar ke dekhen ki aakhir education mein ho kya raha, government kar kya raha hai education ke liye, kis tarike ke bacche jo government schools mein aa rahe hain, kis tarike ke teacher kaam kar raha hai. Agar एक सोसाइटी को चेंज करना है जिसका हम सभी सपना देखते हैं, सभी चाहते हैं कि हम एक अच्छे समाज में रहें, तो अगर जिनके पास ये सपना है समाज को कुछ बदलने का, समाज के लिए कुछ करने का, तो स्कूल से अच्छी मुझे नहीं लगता कोई जगह होगी.
फॉर एनी सिस्टम
or for the success of any system or a policy, we need implementation. So for giving a good implementation at the ground root level, fellowship gives us the experience. It teaches us how to go beyond the science, how to experience the science. So I think the fellowship is a good program to experience the grassroots level of the society.
The fellows during the 2 years with us are posted in a typically a block or what is called a taluk. And they develop superior education understanding and they develop local context. So they know the teachers, they know the nuances of the culture of the place. So if they have done well with us and over 2 years they also develop an interest in working with us for the future, and if they see this as their career, then we do absorb them and continue them in the same district. The nature of their work continues to build on what they have learned through the fellowship program. They would have become better at a subject area. They would have developed better education perspectives. They would have improved their understanding of classrooms. So they use all of this to work with teachers. So they become like very able resource persons for the foundation and in full-fledged roles. After they do their 2 year fellowship program, many of the fellows get absorbed by our own foundation, and that's one avenue. Some of the fellows in the past have gone on to start their own schools. Some of them have started education NGOs, and they are aligned to the good education principles that they have learned in the foundation. Thirdly, there are some fellows who have gone on to do their doctoral work, work in think tanks, influencing education policy, and a few have gone back to where they came from and very substantially enriched on social perspectives, they have gone back to their original places. So we have seen multiple ways in which fellows have used this program for their benefit.